everyone, welcome back to my class. This is Rumana Ali. I hope you all are doing well. In the last session, I have explained you about the two main sense organs, and that were eyes and ears. In today's class, let us move to the other sense organ that helps us to smell, and that is our nose. Nose is a sense organ that helps us to smell different things. So as you all know that the eyes help us to see and the ears help us to hear, likewise nose help us to smell different things. We can identify different items with the help of our nose through smelling. For example, if you smell coriander leaves and cloves, or if you smell cardamom and garlic, so these are the different items that has strong smell. By smelling these things, we can taste them. So these are the different food products that have very strong smell. So besides the sensation of smell, besides smelling, nose also helps us to carry out one important function, and that is called as respiration. So what do you mean by respiration? Respiration is nothing but breathing air in and out through nostrils. This is called as respiration. Nostrils are the two holes that are present in your nose. The two holes of your nose the two holes of our nose can be called as nostrils. So whenever we breathe the air in and out, that process is called as respiration, and it can be carried out, it is possible only through our sense organ called nose. So smelling is one of its main functions. Besides that, respiration is also an important one that can be done with the help of our sense organ called nose. Respiration. In the process of respiration, two steps are involved. One is inhalation and the other one is exhalation. Inhalation means breathing air in. This is called as inhalation. Whenever we breathe the air in, that is called as inhalation, and whenever we breathe the air out through nostrils, then that process is called as exhalation. So inhalation is nothing but taking the air in through our nostrils, and exhalation means giving out the air through our nostrils again. So these are the two steps, inhalation and exhalation. These two steps are involved in the process of respiration that can be achieved only with our sense organ called nose. So sense organ nose helps us in smelling and identifying different things, and also in process of respiration. So it's our responsibility to take care of our sense organ called nose, which is a delicate organ. We should not insert any of the things like pencils or sticks or any other thing into our nose. It can damage our nose, and different problems may occur because of this. So we should take care of it. If in case accidentally anything gets stuck into your nostril, consult the doctor immediately. And if you are unable to breathe properly, then you should go to the hospital immediately. So in this way, we can take care of our special sense organ called nose that helps us to smell and also help us to breathe. So this is about our sense organ called nose. So nose is a sense organ जो different things को smell करने के लिए help करता है, और smelling के साथ साथ respiration के लिए भी nose help करता है. Nose एक ऐसा sense organ है जो respiration को भी carry out करने के लिए help करता है. तो respiration मतलब सांस लेना और सांस बाहर निकालना, इस चीज़ को respiration बोलेंगे. तो जब भी हम सांस अंदर लेते हैं उस process को inhalation बोलेंगे, और जब भी सांस बाहर निकलेगी उस process को हम एक्सहेलेशन बोलेंगे. तो ये इनहेलेशन और एक्सहेलेशन, ये दो स्टेप्स है रेस्पिरेशन के प्रोसेस में. और सांस अंदर और बाहर हमारे सेंस ऑर्गन की मदद से ही होती है, जो कि है नोज. नोज के अंदर जो टू होल्स होते हैं उनको नॉस्ट्रल्स बोलेंगे, और नॉस्ट्रल्स की मदद से ही वी कैन ब्रीथ इन एंड आउट. सो दिस इज अबाउट आवर डेलिकेट एंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट सेंस ऑर्गन दैट हेल्प्स अस टू सर्वाइव. इफ़ यू अनएबल टू ब्रीथ, कैन यू सर्वाइव? नो, obviously no. So nose is an important sense organ that helps us to makes us alive, that helps us to breathe, and that helps us to identify the different things through smelling. So we must always take care of our sense organ called nose. We must always keep it clean. We can easily breathe in and out the air through our nostrils. Can you hold your tongue and speak? No, you can't. So tongue is another sense organ that helps us to speak, and even that helps us to taste the food. So we all know that the tongue is a sense organ that helps us to speak properly, and it also helps to identify the different tastes of the different food. When you observe the structure of the tongue, you can find the presence of taste buds on the surface of your tongue. These taste buds are of different kinds, and these different taste buds are responsible to identify the different tastes, whether the food is sweet or it is salty or it's spicy or it is bitter in taste. All these different kinds of tastes can be identified by the taste buds which are present on the surface of our tongue. So tongue plays an important role as it helps us to speak and also helps us to taste the different kinds of food. So we should keep our mouth clean. Rinse your mouth twice a day, or rinse your mouth after eating and before eating the food. So if you do so, you can keep your mouth clean, and even you should clean your tongue in the morning as well as in the evening. If you rinse your mouth or if you clean the tongue, you can keep your mouth clean and the bad smell can be prevented, and even you can be free from different infections. If you do not rinse, if you do not wash your mouth properly, or if you do not clean your tongue properly, then it may result in the production of germs. Means the germs can be seen, or the germs can be grown into your mouth, and it can spoil your teeth as well as your tongue. You can get some infections in your mouth. So to prevent that infections, to prevent bad breath, and to prevent the damage to your tongue and teeth, you should always rinse your mouth before and after eating, and you should always try to keep your mouth clean. Now one question is, only tongue is helping you to eat the food? No, along with the tongue, teeth are also present in your mouth that helps us to chew the food, that helps us to bite the different food products. So teeth are also important parts that are helping us to chew the food properly. So if we have the food, then that food gets cut into smaller pieces with the help of our teeth. When they are broken into smaller pieces, they get mixes up with the saliva, and after mixing up with the saliva, with the help of our tongue, we can taste it. So we can know the taste of the different food products only after it gets broken down into smaller pieces and mixes up with the saliva. So the people who are not having their teeth, they cannot even taste their food properly. So along with the tongue, teeth also helps us to taste the different food products. And when we talk about the types of teeth, do you know how many teeth are present in a human being? There are 32 teeth that are present in a human being, and these are of 4 different types of teeth can be seen in a human being. And they are, first one is incisors, canines, premolars, and molars. Incisors are the teeth which helps us to chew the food properly, which helps us to bite the food properly. So these are also called as biting teeth, as they are helping in biting the different food items. The next one is canines. Canines are the teeth that helps us to tear the food properly. So as they are helping in tearing, they are called as tearing teeth. And the teeth which helps us to chew the food properly, they are called as chewing teeth, and they are premolars. So premolars are also called as chewing teeth, as they help us to chew the food properly. And molars are also called as grinding teeth, as they help to grind the food into our mouth. So these are the 4 different kinds of teeth that you can see in your mouth. First one is incisors, which are also called as biting teeth. Canines are also called as tearing teeth. Premolars are also called as chewing teeth. And molars are also called as grinding teeth. So different types of teeth helps in carrying the different processes. Some teeth are helping in chewing the food properly, and they are termed as premolars, and some of them are helping in biting the food. So they are called as canines. In such a way, the four different types of teeth are present in our mouth. But when the child is small, at that time he don't have complete all 32 teeth. He is having 20 or 22 teeth in his. The teeth that appear first in children, they are called as temporary teeth. When these teeth falls off at the age of 8 to 10 years, the new teeth will grow, new teeth will come, and that teeth are called as permanent teeth. If this permanent teeth falls off, then no teeth will grow. So it's our duty to keep our mouth clean, to brush twice a day, and to keep our teeth clean and free from decay. So if we do not brush our teeth twice a day, then the tooth decay can, the bacteria can grow into your mouth, and it makes your teeth loosen and the teeth may fall off. So if that permanent teeth falls off, new teeth will not grow and you cannot enjoy the taste of the different food. So it is very, very important to brush our teeth twice a day and to keep our mouth and teeth clean. And when we have the food products, pieces of the food get stuck into our teeth. When we rinse our mouth, it can be washed off. So it is compulsory to rinse our mouth before and after eating so that we can keep our mouth and teeth clean. We can keep our tongue and teeth clean. If we do not do, or if we do not rinse our mouth, then bacteria can grow, your gums can swell and bleed, and even your teeth color is going to be changed. So to prevent all these problems, you need to keep your teeth and mouth clean. You need to brush your teeth twice, and you need to clean your tongue in the morning as well as in the evening. By following all these things, you can keep your mouth clean and you can prevent different infections. तो यहाँ पर tongue और teeth, ये दो ऐसे important organs हैं जो कि taste को identify करने के लिए help करते हैं. ठीक है, tongue के ऊपर taste buds present होते हैं जो different taste को identify करने के लिए हमारी help करते हैं, और teeth ऐसे organs हैं जो food products को bite, cut करना, bite और chew करने के लिए help करते हैं. इस बेसिस पर फोर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ टीथ प्रेजेंट होते हैं, वो हैं इंसीजर्स, केनाइंस, प्रीमोलार्स और मोलार्स. इंसीजर्स ऐसे वाले टीथ होते हैं जो हमें कोई भी फूड प्रोडक्ट को बाइट करने के लिए हेल्प करते हैं, इसके लिए इसको बाइटिंग टीथ भी बोला जाएगा. केनाइंस यानी कोई भी फूड प्रोडक्ट को टेयर करने के लिए हेल्प करते हैं, इसके लिए इसको टेयरिंग टीथ. और कोई भी फूड प्रोडक्ट को च्यू करने के लिए जो टीथ हेल्प करते हैं उनको हम प्रीमोलार्स बोलेंगे, और इसको च्यूइंग टीथ भी बोला जा सकता है. और मोलार्स को ग्राइंडिंग टीथ भी बोला जा सकता है क्योंकि ये वाले ऐसे टीथ होते हैं जो फूड को ग्राइंड करने के लिए हेल्प करते हैं. सो इन दिस वे फोर टाइप्स ऑफ डिफरेंट टीथ कैन बी सीन इन आवर माउथ. एंड इवन टेम्प्ररी टीथ भी प्रेजेंट होते हैं और परमानेंट टीथ भी. जो फर्स्ट टीथ आते हैं उनको टेम्प्ररी टीथ या फिर हम मिल्क टीथ भी बोल सकते हैं. ये वाले टीथ फॉल ऑफ होने के बाद में 8 to 10 ईयर्स में ये जब फॉल ऑफ हो जाते हैं तब न्यू टीथ ग्रो होते हैं और इनको हम परमानेंट टीथ बोलेंगे. टीथ ऐसे इंपॉर्टेंट ऑर्गन हैं जो हमें फूड के टेस्ट को आइडेंटिफाई करने के लिए हेल्प करते हैं और उसको चीव करने के लिए भी हेल्प करते हैं. टीथ, माउथ को क्लीन रखना इज अवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. सो टू कीप अवर माउथ क्लीन, वी शुड ब्रश एंड वी शुड रिंस अवर माउथ डेली. सो हाउ शुड वी टेक केयर ऑफ अवर टीथ? बाई ब्रशिंग दैम ट्वाइस एंड बाई रबिंग अवर गम्स विद अवर फिंगर, बाई ईटिंग डिफरेंट फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स, वी कैन कीप अवर टीथ healthy and strong. And we should not use coal powder and some other products which are harsh and coarse because it can damage your gums. If the gums or enamel gets damaged, enamel is the hard covering which is present in your mouth and which the teeth are attached. So if that layer is going to be damaged, then you cannot keep your teeth healthy and strong. So it's your responsibility to avoid sweets and sugar, and also to avoid the use of coal powder and other coarse and harsh material to rub the teeth, and always massage the gums to keep them healthy, and eat fruits and vegetables. By following all these measures, you can keep your teeth healthy and strong. Our last sense organ is skin. Skin is a sense organ that covers the different parts of our body. All the parts of our body are covered by the skin. So what is the function of the skin? Skin protects our body and it also helps us to touch. So it protects the different organs of our body and it also helps in the sensation of touch. We can feel heat, cold, hardness or the softness of the different objects by touch, that is with the help of a sense organ called skin. So we should keep our skin clean and healthy. So to keep our skin clean and healthy, we should bathe twice a day, that is in the morning and also in the evening. While bathing, rub the body parts thoroughly so that it can get clean, and rub your skin properly so that it can be washed in a proper manner. And what else you want to follow is drink as much water as you can. Drinking water can replenish your skin and can make your skin healthy and glowing. And to protect your skin during winter season, you need to apply Vaseline and moisturizer on your body. And you need to wear cotton clothes and the loose clothes during summer season. So in this way, you can keep your skin healthy, you can protect your skin, and even you can keep your skin free from different infections. So these are the different measures that you need to follow to protect your sense organ called skin, which is an important sense organ that covers all the body parts, and even it is protecting your internal organs too. So keep your skin healthy and glowing by following all the measures which I told you just before. We shake hands with our friends whenever we meet, and while going to school or while going to home or while traveling, you can touch on many surfaces, and on that surfaces different microorganisms may present, and that microorganisms can stuck onto your palm or onto your skin. So it's better to wash your hands before eating anything. Before eating anything, you must wash your hands so that the microbes that are present on your skin, it can be washed away. So wash your hands thoroughly before eating anything. This helps you to be healthy, because if that microorganisms enters into your body, then that microorganisms are responsible to cause different diseases. So it's better to wash your hands and stop the entry of microorganisms into your body. So in this way, you can prevent different diseases and even you can keep your skin healthy and clean. So skin is first affected by the changes that occurs in the surrounding. If you protect skin, skin will protect you. It's your responsibility to keep your skin clean and healthy by following all the measures which we have discussed. And you can observe some ridges and grooves that are present in your palm. And the linings are also found on your palm. These are your fingerprint. No two persons in the world can have similar fingerprints. This kind of lines or the fingerprints that are present on your palm, that are found on the skin of your palm, helps in many processes, like in doing the DNA fingerprinting process, in finding the criminals. In all such activities, fingerprinting is very important. So no two persons in the world can have similar fingerprints. So in this chapter, we have discussed about the different sense organs. We know that we have 5 sense organs, and they are eyes, nose, ears, tongue, and skin. We have discussed their importance and also the measures that needs to be followed to protect these sense organs and to keep them healthy. So you should always follow all that measures which we have discussed in this lesson to protect your sense organs. It's the gift of the nature. You might have seen some children, they are having sense organs, but that sense organs do not function properly. Eyes that are present in a children, if he cannot be able to see, then that sense organ is useless. It is not functioning properly. So you should always appreciate the role of your sense organs and always try to protect them and keep them healthy. And the persons whose sense organs are not functioning properly, you should help that needy people. And government is also organizing many different health camps for that children to provide necessary arrangement for their education. Because the children whose sense organs are not functioning properly, they are also having right to education. So in this way, many camps, many programs are organizing by the government to fulfill the needs of all these impaired children. Here the lesson, our body parts, sense organ ends. I hope it's clear to you. Meet you in next class. Thank you.